Welcome to today's Grow It Green. We're at the Urban Forestry Center in Portsmouth, and this looks like a normal beam until you see something's missing from the inside. Here to explain what caused this and maybe another pest as well, Rachel Massini from UNH Cooperative Extension. So Rachel, what are we dealing with here?
This particular beam was infested with carpenter ants, Ray, and it was kind of interesting, but this is what we were finding at the exit holes. And I had the owner go back, vacuum these up, and then go back again. And if they saw this, then we know that there was a carpenter ant issue.
And that it was active as well.
Exactly. This time of year, a lot of people call the education center because they're seeing swarms of insects in the home, and they want to know whether it's carpenter ants or termites. So hopefully today, you'll have a better understanding of the two differences. Carpenter ants, primarily, they're a hymenopter group. They have elbowed antennas. So if you were to look at the antenna close up, they'd have an elbow shape. They also have a constricted waist. It looks like somebody has pulled a string really, really tight. Their wings are dissimilar. Their front wings are larger than their hind wings. The termite, on the other hand, has straight antenna. They actually look like chains of pearls. Their body is very broad. They don't have that constriction, and their wings are the same size and shape.
Okay, so looking at some of the damage, I mean, we showed this that beam as well, but it, most of them, I guess, gather what you're going to find are these little holes, right, with the you call frass down below.
Correct. You may see some holes here, and you will definitely see this frass. So if you vacuum this up and you go back and you see more frass, then you know that you have an active colony there. With termites, they're a little more subdued. They're dirtier. You would see tubing on the outside of maybe foundations, maybe inside your home. If you do have an issue, you'll see those tubings. They are very prone to desiccation, so they actually create highways or travel tubes in order for them to stay moist.
Now, you mentioned, too, that the when it comes to the carpenter ants, they're not actually ingesting the wood, though, right?
No, they're excavating. So they're actually living in that wood environment. The termites, on the other hand, they do ingest.
Okay.
And they will eat that.
Now, one thing we haven't gotten into was how to treat this, but you say don't try to do this by yourself.
I would not try to do this yourself. I definitely recommend consulting with a pesticide control operator.
Okay, so go down to your basement, some other places in your home, take a look, and hopefully you won't find any of this. That's it for today's Grow It Green.